Hey, Redemption Tucson. My name's Steven, one of the pastors here. Got my wife, Kelsey, on this video, so it'll actually be good. And I wanted to share with you just some of the ways that we're following Jesus in this season, individually and as a family. Like, what is Bible? What is prayer? What does worship? What does rest look like in this season? And so I want to just share some of these things and really inspire us to walk and follow Jesus, because we can't lead others. We're not going to be able to serve our families, point them to Jesus. We can't give away something we don't have. So I want to inspire you to walk and serve and follow Jesus. So Kels, what does this season look like for you as far as walking with the Lord?
Yeah, for my time in the Word, I've been using this Hebrews study guide. It was created by the Women of Redemption Tempe, and here in Tucson, we're actually going to utilize it this summer. So just a lot in there, cross-references, study, prayer requests, reflections, prayer journaling, scripture memory. That's been really helpful.
And for me, what it's been look like in the season is I am reading through the Psalms, and that's been really rich for me. I'm reading like two or three a day, and I'm journaling out the Psalms and turning them into prayer. So for me, I have a hard time focusing when I'm definitely praying silently, but even praying aloud, I can get pretty distracted. And so for me, journaling out my prayers has been really helping me. And so, like, for instance, I just read Psalm 91, and when it talks about God delivering us from the snares and that God's our refuge, I'm journaling this out, saying, God, you are my refuge. Help me to rest in you. Help me to trust you more this day. And then I'm going to journal out some things that I'm struggling to trust God with. And so I'm really taking these Psalms, appropriating them to my life, and turning them into prayers. And that's been really, really good for me. And again, this is like a 15 to 20 minute process. This is not hours in the morning, but this is just setting aside a few minutes to orient my life around God each day, because I need him, we need him. And so a couple other tools, just if you're like, I need something. And so we have a bunch of books and things in front of us. We're gonna try to go quick, but this book by Paul Tripp, it's a devotional called New Morning Mercies. We have a bunch of these that were actually given to us. And this is great. We've done this as a couple. I've done this individually. It's like each day is just one page. And I know you can't see that, but each day is one page. And that's been really helpful. Also, if you're struggling with prayer, which is historically been really hard for me to experience, just I say prayers, but the richness has been hard to really press into. Paul Miller's book, A Praying Life, is fantastic. I cannot recommend that high enough. I'll put all these resources in the video description or on social media, but A Praying Life by Paul Miller, New Morning Mercies by Paul Tripp are just great resources. And so that's some of what we're doing individually, but we also talk about what we're doing as a family. So two rhythms, our family worship night and a family Sabbath and a time of rest. So Kels, could you share what are we doing for this family worship night? It might be easy. Worship pastor, it must be easy for you. Like, what does this actually look like?
Yeah, it is a weekly time for us, so Monday nights for us, that we set apart for family time and to worship the Lord together. And so a lot of times that looks like us cooking dinner together and worshiping God through creation and food. We'll sit down with one another and ask a couple basic questions or intentional questions, mix it up a little bit. If you have a prayer board, this is a great time to pray for others across the world, your family issues. It's a good time to just get face to face and talk and pray and eat. And then after that, we sing songs. So like Stephen said, he plays the guitar and sings, but we don't always do that. Sometimes we put on some YouTube videos of worship music and have a dance party. We love the Risers. That's a kids worship band, and our son Levi loves it too. And so we'll dance and sing together. When we put our son down for bed, we'll read him a story from the Jesus Storybook Bible, or when that was too old and long for him, we would read some basic books like First Bible Basics. This is a whole series, Baby Believer series. They have fantastic books that are geared toward babies and toddlers. Another one we love is The Biggest Story, ABC by Kevin DeYoung. There's a bigger storybook version for a little bit older kids too. And we love The Garden, The Curtain, and The Cross. This is one in a series at probably 10. They're still coming out with new ones called Tales That Tell the Truth, just from different biblical stories and themes. And then this is our Jesus Storybook Bible that we
read from.
Yeah, Stephen's grandma. So Levi's great-grandma gave us this gift edition. But I know the children at Redemption Tucson also get those as a gift when they're dedicated.
So. Yeah. And the last rhythm we have is a family that's just, and again, I hope this like demystifies, like this is what we're doing, what it looks like to follow Jesus as a family, is rest, is a time to just set aside our phones, set aside our work, connect with one another and rest and connect with the Lord. And so it looks like putting our phones away for a big chunk of the day on Friday and just waking up and cooking breakfast together. And for us, that looks like getting outside and doing walks at the U of A or going down to Reed Park and feeding the ducks, kicking the soccer ball around and just resting, praising God for who he is and what he's given us, and slowing down, eating lunch together. And then we're praying throughout that day, and we're reading the Jesus Storybook Bible throughout that day. And we're, that Friday nights, we do family movie night. And again, just a time for us to unwind. It's not just a day off. It's time for us to connect with God and connect with one another. And so that's what we're doing. Again, a family worship night on Monday, that's like 30 to 45 minutes. It's not like this massive, long ordeal. You know, we Sabbath, again, on Fridays, we're slowing down, putting our phones away, connecting with God and with one another. And then we have those tools we're saying that we're doing as you know, adults walking with Jesus. And so we hope this gives you some tools, some tracks to run on. And I know many people are like, how do I follow Jesus? What are we doing in this season? Here's some tools for you. And we look forward to seeing you soon.